Hi friends, welcome to my channel Tech Plugin.
So friends, today our topic is about the WAMP 64 server. If you don't see my previous video about the WordPress, then just click on this the link I'm giving in the description box. So check this. Here we learn today how to install and set up the WAMP server and also how we create our website. So let's see. Here I'm write the WAMP 64 for a Windows 10, and here you see the two links, where first one is the WAMP server links and second one is the source fog link. Okay, so in a previous video I am giving the second link because the first site means first link is down. So right now you see here, this is a WAMP server means all the home page, and here you see the all the options. So click on the download options. So guys, main thing here you required the space on a C drive. Here are the two our system. First is the 64 and the second is the 32, choice as per your requirement. Here I am choosing the 64 bit. Here you see the option, you can download it directly. Just click on this and start your downloading. First thing guys, this is required for only the local host. It's not providing you the means a live server. Okay, here you see the source fog, this which I'm giving you the first. And here the our application is ready. So just I'm selecting the folder and okay, I'm just save this. After this selection, here you see the wamp.exe means the file our. Then click the run as administrator. Here you see the option like the select the setup language. So here I'm selecting English because there are the only two languages, and click on the okay. Here you see the license agreement option. Just read the license agreement if you want. If you don't, then just click on the I accept the agreement and click on the next. Here you see the information guys. Here the information is required for the WAMP server in your PC, like your means FS server, your Visual CC. Here the Visual CC package is show only for the means CC packages, which is a 2000 from means redistributor files is located in here. For the WAMP server is a really needy thing to run your WAMP server in your PC. So here is something warning, then click on the next, and here you see the folder location. I am recommended to you to store this on a C drive, not any other drive, because our the PHP MyAdmin all things are stuff in here. Here in the components there are the two options, and I'm seeing the default means installation option. Here the WAMP server Apache PHP, you see the PHP old version also. You see if you click on this, the means a disk space is increasing, so we are not clicking this. The new PHP version is already installed for this. Then the MariaDB and MySQL both are for the database. Both are work as the same as the creating database and all the things stuff is same. So here the MySQL option I'm selected because we know the MariaDB and MySQL is both of the requirement. You create the MariaDB also and MySQL also. So I'm here to show you. Here MySQL I'm selected, and you see the disk space is greater. Okay, here the WAMP 64 server is a launcher which is created in our desktop startup menu. So after that you see here the destination, folder location, setup and the setup components and the menu folder. So first thing the destination location, which is our CWAMP 64 which you selected. Here our setup type is custom default. We set up a default, it show a custom. Here you see the components which we selected. Here the MySQL also show you, and the start menu folder of a WAMP 64. Right now the downloading is starting. Guys, make sure you have a specific storage in your drive. If you want to store in another drive, so make sure all these files and all the requirements are correctly working. And here the installation is continue process. Okay, here they are asking for you the browser. If you want the iExplorer browser, then you click on the yes. If you don't know, and if you want to choose another one, then click on the no. Here I'm selecting no because I want another one. And here I am selecting the Google Chrome browser. So going for the Google, going from the Chrome application, and choose the chrome.exe file, which is execution file guys. So click on the next, and here you see the notepad. If you want to the simple notepad, then you click on the yes. If you don't want the simple notepad, then you click on the no. And here I am choosing the Sublime text. So guys, the first thing is for the Sublime text is help to create which show you all the setup is not like a notepad, which is the stuff is not clear. Okay, here you see after that successful hey, the warning. It may be first launch, not all the services are started. Means icon it's not a green. Then make sure you just restart the services. For some explanation on how web server is work, see the file. Here the two types of file is provided, like instruction for a use and the okay, this is the RTF file and the PDF file. Okay, after that just click on the next. Here your current version is showed, 3.2.0. guys, this is the launcher which we see in the desktop. Choose the run as the administration, means administrator option. Here you see the window that is ask you, do you want to allow this app or yes or no. Just click on the yes, and this type of command are continue executing to start this WAMP server. So first thing guys, here you see on the right hand corner WAMP server, none of the three services are running. That's why it showed the red. After this, if it's not going for the green, you just restart it. Where is now the orange, and the two of the three services are currently running. And here, the all services are running. Okay, this is currently working as a green. So our setup is completely successful. So just click the left click, and here you see the localhost option. The first option is a localhost. The click on this. Here you see all the localhost, which is the configuration for the Apache server, the server software, the PHP version, the your load means extensions, your MariaDB version, your MySQL version. Guys, I'm already tell you, you just if you want the documentation on this also, just I'm providing you. And here you see your project. If you created the project, then this project are showing here. The tools which provided by the local server is here. The LSS and your virtual host is always a local host. You not type here HTTPS and anything. Just type a local host. You are a pro, means you are a folder name or your project name, and then set up to do. Okay, here. Here first we go our which where we means save our WAMP sim in a 64C drive, the WAMP 64 folder. Just click on this, and you here see the WW option. Okay, here all this means required things are the previously downloaded. Okay, then click on WW. Here also you see the plugin, the themes and the favicon icon, the index and many more things. Just create a new folder and give your project name. Here I am giving the means first project. Make sure you don't make or to take some difference on this. Because of this, means when you type on this on your browser searching bar, so it's get a percentage on the beach of this means of this space. So make sure you always write to connected. Okay, here I am writing the first project. So okay, I'm refreshing this. Here you see your project name. The first project is always means showing right here. First thing guys, when we created it, the folder, it's always empty. So here we go for the WordPress installation. Write the wordpress.org, which the link I'm providing you in my description box guys. So here the 5.4.2 version is released on the June 10, means 4 days ago guys, the new version is released. So for this, the click on the get WordPress. After the clicking on the get WordPress, you see here the down the option to download your WordPress 5.4.2. just click on this, and yes, your download is start. Guys, this is not a big software or it is consume your net, your means space. It is just a little bit software. So make sure you just save this on your project file. Here I'm saving in a first project file. Here I am saving this. So the 4.1 means here only the 12.6 MB is required to download the WordPress and the setup the WordPress. So guys, this is means if you don't know what if the WordPress providers, then see my previous video. I am there give the all the information about the WordPress. Okay, so here the means our WordPress installation is completed, and I'm just rename this the first project because I'm told you don't make a space on this. So yeah, I'm this save like this. Okay, after this when you open the first project, yeah, here the completed. Here you see the WordPress 5.4.2 zip is available. This extract the file. I'm here using for the WinCap software to extract this. So here you see the WordPress 5.4.2 folder is available right now guys. So here I'm extracting the, and you see this, how it's means loading faster. It's not take us such a time, and you consuming your net and all the things stuff like. Okay, in this folder you see the WordPress, and in the WordPress folder you see all the content which is, or which all this requirements here. So here I am cut my WordPress folder and paste it above or the previous means here, and I am deleting the WordPress 5.4.2. okay, because of this guys, if you write and if you just providing on the browser localhost, then you want to provide also the WordPress 5.4.2, then what means your project name, then WordPress 5.4, then WordPress, this is such a big, so you don't require this all things. Okay, so right now we can open the new tab, and here we just write localhost slash which is your project name, which here my project name is the first project, and then just means slash, because of guys because this is a localhost, so you don't need to do. Now this is our the setup here, the WordPress 5.4.2 zip you show here, and the WordPress option you show here. So first click on the WordPress for the next next setup. Here I'm clicking the WordPress, and okay, here you see all the languages which is available for your WordPress, or you understand this, like all the means which country they are supported, all the languages you here see. Also here the Marathi and the Hindi language also the available, and many more language in India. So here I'm choosing the English option, and I'm just do continue. Here you see the pop-up is open, and here you see the welcome to the WordPress, and they require the database name, database username, database password, database host, and table prefix guys. So this all things is required in our wp-config.php file which we want to made this. Okay, then come to the WordPress folder, and here you see all the options. Just wp-config-sample-php is here you see, just copy and paste it here, and here just rename it by the WP config. Okay, removing the sample means copy all the thing. The my extensions are show because I am in a view mode. I am just means click on the show the extension. You can means it's means if your extensions are not show like a PHP or .html, then this is show only the WP means dash config file. Okay, here you see in the right hand corner, just click on the left and select the PHP my admin option guys. Here I'm seeing the selecting PHP my admin. Provide your username. If you don't have a password, then don't provide. If you the new user, then you don't have a password. If you just set up the password, then password, and select your server choice, which is a MariaDB and or MySQL, and select your language and click on the just go button. Here you see of the PHP my admin dashboard guys. For the MariaDB and MySQL means both are the same, so you don't need to worry about this setup. So here I'm clicking on the new for creating the new database. From the creating, here I'm write a project one. So here I'm choosing this, all are the our Unicode. So here I'm choosing means UT8MB4 general CA, and just click on the create. Here you see the database are created, but this database are empty because we are not creating the site. If when you creating the site, when you means set up the WordPress, then this also created the table. Here in WP config file, just open this. You open in anything like a Sublime Text, you are normally Notepad and all the thing. Okay, here you see the MySQL setting, and you can get into from your web host. This is all we want to change it. How just to see here, we now the create our database name here, which is the project one, and here also it show this here you see the project one which gave the name here, the database name we provided, also the username which is we give in our login. This is root for the database. I'm providing here root. Here you give the password. If you don't have a password, just leave it blank. The local, here you see the DB host name, the local host. Make sure you don't change the local host. If you put it the local host another, so you do this, but don't change guys. Here the UTF at MB4 I'm giving the option, and don't do anything here. Okay, what we change first, the database of WordPress, the database username, the database password, the MySQL host name, and means we are not changing the host name, just remaining as it is. Here I am changing the creating database table and nothing else, guys. Okay, so make sure you save this file correctly. I am saving this and I am close this. Okay, fine. Here now you click on the let's go option. So I am clicking here the let's go. And guys, here they ask you, means they detect your wp.config file and they give you two permission for the installing. Here you choose the language for your WordPress. I'm choosing the English language here. Okay, here you see the pop-up will occur, and here you they ask for your site title, your username, your password and your email and the search engine visibility. So I am here giving the site title is STM. This is a dummy. Okay, I am giving admin for the username. Here you not provide your database username and the password. Here only you provide your username, which you want to give to your site, guys. So here I'm username is my admin. Here I'm password is give at the rate sundigital2020@. Okay, yes, it's make a strong. Make sure guys your password is always strong, and you copy this password in your file first because we need for this login. Okay, enter your email ID here. We provide the email ID because guys, if any problem is occurred in our website, then it will help us to do means such a to help this. Then make sure you don't do anything in a search engine visibility and click on the installing WordPress. After the installing WordPress, this procedure happening here. Fine. After the installing, you see the success message, your admin, and they ask for your the password. So here click on the login and you see I'm here typing my the previous is admin and the password which I providing here. Okay, this is a sundigital2020@, and just click on the login. After the login guys, you see the WordPress dashboard is now ready for you. Here you see the dashboard post and the all these things. When I'm clicking to visit my site, here you see the site is also ready. This is the website template, guys. And
hey guys, if you like watching this video, then like us, subscribe to my channel, share my videos, and don't forget to press the bell icon for the new updates. Thank you.